Okay, y'all. I have noticed that I've had some new subscribers. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. I've been having some interesting conversations today with an old friend of mine. And we were discussing what is wrong with our government. And the topic of conversation led to looking into, first of all, bills. How bills are huge, unreadable, completely ridiculous, and filled with all sorts of garbage that has nothing to do with the main bill. And I've been saying this for years. I think that if it's about something, like say you have a bill that says, you know, instead of, this would be a very liberal bill, but anybody who lives in this city can apply to get a free bicycle to ride back and forth to work to save the city from being smoggy. Okay? Say that's a bill. You don't tack on to that bill something about giving money to Canada or Mexico or China or Libya or any other country. You don't tack anything onto that bill. If that bill passes, it passes on its merits. If it doesn't pass, it doesn't pass. And the same goes for any other bill that comes onto the floor of Congress. Goes through the Senate. Goes to the President. It has to be legible within a reasonable amount of time. It has to be able to be understood, debated, and voted on by educated voters. Some things, even, and I was thinking about this even more so, is we're not really represented by our legislature. Okay? We vote these people in. But after we vote them in, they don't come to us and say, hey, how do you feel about the bicycle bill? Let me take a poll of the people in my area. Do you people want the bicycle bill? Or do you not want the bicycle bill? And then they vote accordingly. And that's what they're supposed to do. They're supposed to represent our opinions. Not their opinions, or not the opinions of the people who are paying the money, the lobbyists, the corporations, the special interest groups. They're supposed to ask our opinions. They're not supposed to take money from lobbyists, corporations, special interest groups, because that's basically like a pay-for-play. It's obvious when somebody donates a large portion or sum to a politician's campaign, to a politician or any kind of setup, an ideal like the bicycle bill, for instance, that they've got an agenda. What if they're the people that make the tiniest part on that bicycle, the spokes in the wheel? Or they're the people that import the metal that the bicycle is going to be made out of? Or the rubber the tires are going to be made out of? Or the foam the seat's going to be made out of? How can we tell, without doing extensive research, that these people don't have a dog in the race? How do we know? We don't. We rarely ever get that much information. So, when it comes down to bills that are being passed, like this one with the COVID relief, for instance, this is our money. This is our money, from taxation, okay? The money that came out of our paychecks, the money that we used when we bought stuff and we paid taxes for it, goes into legislature, law, bills, lawmakers' pockets, basically. Everything within the system is twisted and corrupted. And there's no doubt in my mind about this. I've been watching politics and the political system for close to 20 years. I started getting my interest sparked right after 9/11, give or take, and it just snowballed from there. I campaigned for Ron Paul because I liked his very libertarian ideas, and I did not get to vote for him, unfortunately. My state decided at the very last moment to pass a law that said you cannot write in candidates in the presidential election, which they later said was completely unconstitutional according to the state constitution, but it was too late at that point. I remember walking in that polling booth, closing that curtain, and then hollering to the lady who had walked me over there and put the little cartridge in the side of the polling machine. "Hey, how do I do a write-in vote for the president?" And she says, "Oh, you can't. We outlawed this year." And I stood there staring. In front of me, two names, neither of whom I desired to vote for. I finally decided not to vote for Obama, and choked down the bitter taste of voting for McCain. It's unforgivable, in my opinion, to have to do that. But that's what I had to do. At that moment in time, I was lost. I hadn't. What else could I do? I certainly wasn't voting for a socialist, and I could see Obama coming a mile away. In any case, what I was getting at is, these politicians are corrupt as can be. These are the bullies of grade school, okay? These are the whiny, nasty, take-your-lunch-money type bullies. And somehow or another, they've got into power, and they are getting, you know, if they weren't the bully, they were the kid that was picked on, and you know, they went through some sort of college or whatever, and now they're getting revenge. So it's either the bullies or the people getting the revenge, and I think that they're all infiltrated all through the government, and they're all on the take in one manner or another. Some of the take that they're on is legal, like taking money from lobbyists, and some of the take is totally illegal, like what's going on with the CCP. But the thing is, we have to do something about this system. This system was put together when the country was young. Our voting, our way of voting, okay? Our way of writing law. It was put together when the system was 13 colonies, basically. At the time, only people who paid taxes who were landowners could vote. And then later on, voting rights came to other people. But at that point in time, it was easier to ask your constituents as a senator or a congressman what the people of that area thought about a law. You could go to the local pub, sit down, and talk to your constituents. You were part of the community. There wasn't this hoity-toity around Washington, D.C. neighborhood where, you know, all the senators and congressmen are living behind gated walls, okay? There are people who lived in communities. These were farmers and local doctors and professors and lawyers and business people. People who were part of the community. And they knew what their constituents really wanted. It wasn't like it is today. And they cared what their constituents wanted. These people don't give a freaking flying mm-mm, okay? They don't care one bit what we want. All they want to do is get rich and be mildly famous, remembered by history. And you know what? They're going to be remembered by history as the evil bastards they are. But the thing is, how do we stop this? What can we do to start being able to have a voice? Basically, this is like the Boston Tea Party. We're in a situation of taxation without representation. Not a single American would vote against having our own money given back to us in this COVID situation. We need that money. Our restaurants that are being shut down, our businesses, our gyms, our hair salons, all these businesses that are not deemed essential, they need that money or they're not going to be there this coming year. They're going to be closed. My parents, my grandparents ran businesses, and I know for a fact that if you do not make a profit throughout an entire year, you're pretty much a goner at that point, unless you're independently wealthy. But not only are you a goner, but everybody that you employ is in a similar situation. And in that happening, everybody around them, who they affect, and it's a snowball. The shutdowns are absolutely ridiculous. And we need to be able to vote on these things. We need a voice. And we don't have one. And that's a situation that our legislature needs to remedy. Perhaps we need to have each representative have a website or have a link in a main website where you can go onto your state's website and vote on whether that legislator needs to vote on a bill, yes or no, yay or nay. And whatever, and have the amount of people that voted and the amount of people and the amount of votes that were counted to yes or no right there on the site. And if that legislator does not follow what those people wanted, and you have to sign in, you have to get an account, sign in with your voter registration card so you can't double vote on it or pack the survey, okay? Only one vote for each person. But you go on there and you vote on the bicycle law, or you vote on this bill that they passed through Congress today that is paying out billions of dollars to other countries for teetotal bull. My money and the money of people that I care about around me and the rest of this country for that matter, who I may not know, but I do care about, for our future, should never be going to other countries when we are in the situation we are in right now. That money needs to go back to our business owners. That money needs to go back to our people. It needs to go into unemployment. It needs to go into these stimulus checks. None of that money needs to go out of this country. And that's all lobbyist, corporate cronyism, pay-for-play bullshit with these politicians that we have. Who wrote that bill? 5,700 pages. Who wrote it? Who decided what was in there? Honestly, who sat down and typed that thing out? I want to know. Don't you? Wouldn't you like to be able to decide if carp get millions of dollars for an experiment? Wouldn't you like to decide if there are gender studies programs in other countries that you were paying for? I know I would. And that's about all I gotta say about it. Anyway, drop me a comment below. Tell me what you think. Please like and subscribe. Thank you. Have a great day.